Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In this video, we will practice Power BI question related to connect Power BI desktop to SQL Server database and understand the default settings. The question is, you are using Power BI desktop to connect to Azure SQL database. The connection is configured as shown in the following exhibit. And in the exhibit on the right side, we can see from Power BI desktop, we need to connect to SQL Server database and all the settings are as default. And here we have two questions to answer. The first question is the default timeout for the connection from Power BI desktop to the database will be. And there we have three options, unlimited, 1 minute or 10 minutes. And the second question is the Navigator will display all the tables from SQL Server, only tables that contains data, only tables that contains hierarchies. So let's see these settings in a Power BI. So here in Power BI, let's connect to SQL Server database. Now we are on the SQL Server database connection window. So let me provide the server name, then database name. And all the remaining settings should be remain as a default as per the given in the exhibit. So here you can see the by default it is showing as a import data connectivity mode. And then under advanced option, we have command timeout in minutes, which is blank. And then we have SQL statement. That is optional if we want to provide the SQL statement. And then we have three checkbox, that is include relationship columns, navigate using full hierarchy. And the last one is enable SQL Server failover support. So let's understand all these advanced properties. So the first property is connection timeout in minutes. That means when Power BI will connect to the SQL Server and execute query on the SQL Server database to extract data from there, then how long it should wait. And if we provide any value over here, let's say 20, then it will execute query for 20 minutes. But if we don't provide anything, then Power BI will not pass any timeout period in the source SQL Server database. And by that time, the whatever timeout value configured in the source database, that will be considered as the timeout window. So for that, let's go to the SQL Server and let's see what is the default timeout period in the SQL Server. So here in a SQL Server database, to check configure timeout period, we need to execute one command, that is execute sp-configure remote query timeout. So let me execute this command. And here we can see we are getting 600 seconds as the remote query timeout. So that means whenever the Power BI will send query to this SQL Server database to read data from the tables, the query will have 600 seconds at the timeout period. So with this, we can understand that the 600 seconds, that is 10 minutes, is the default setting if we are not providing any value over here. And thereafter, the next setting is SQL statement. That is, if we want to provide any custom SQL query to extract data from the source SQL database, then we can provide query over here. In that case, we will not explore all the tables from the source database. Instead, we will get the result from the query itself. And thereafter, under this three checkbox, the first checkbox is include relationship columns. That means if we select any table while exploring all the tables from source database, upon selecting any table, if that table has any reference to the other table, such as foreign key, in that case, it will pull the related table as well. The next setting is navigating using full hierarchy. That means it will give us a complete list of the tables or folder structure from the SQL Server. So let's see that. So here under Object Explorer, if we see we are getting all this folder structure. So this complete folder structure we will get over there. So it will show us like system tables and other folders as well. And the last option is enable SQL Server failover support. That is, if we want to enable SQL Server failover support in the source database. So now let's discuss the second question, that is, if we proceed with this default setting, then what tables we will get? So for that, let's go back to SQL Server. And here under case studies database, we can see under tables, we have two tables. And in table one, we can see we have data. And under table two, we don't have any data. So we can see the table two is blank. So now when we proceed with this default settings from Power BI for SQL Server, let's see what tables we are getting. So here we can see when we click on the OK, we are getting both the tables with data and table 2 that is without data. So with this, in first question, the default timeout for the connection from Power BI desktop to the database will be 10 minutes. And the second question, the navigator will display all the tables, either it has data or not. So the first option is the correct answer.